Okay, well, my apologies. This is permanent rose, that one Viridian, ultramarine, brilliant purple, purple red, crimson, cadmium orange hue, lemon yellow. I've been using them for a while and they've really proved themselves worthy of staying on my palette. And as you know, I have various palettes that I use on and off. And today I just thought of collecting this one because it has its own wells. Now this palette comes in a pack of 4 or 6 and it is a Montmartre brand. I'll see if I can get one of the sets to show you. You'll have to look at this one. It's the only one I have left. Okay. In the beginning of the month, I shared 4 of my healing plants with you, and the last one was the cosmos. And today I'm going to paint my humble little cosmos on a very large watercolor sketchbook. It is a spiral bound, so I can easily remove the pages if I have to, and I've done quite a bit in this book, but I'll keep that as a surprise for some other time. Okay, so initially I just want to investigate the flower a little bit and just orientate my mind into what I'm seeing, and from there on I'll loosely translate that to the page. Looking at the shape of the leaves and the length of the stems, the size of the heads, and also what angle I'd like them to be viewed at. I could easily turn the sketchbook around and have it tall like this. And I think I'll do that while I plan it out. And we can always move it back as soon as the drawing is done. So you can just have a look and we'll see where this one goes. Don't think I'm going to paint all of them. Maybe have that. Today I'm drawing with a watercolor soluble pencil in a light blue. Thank you. although it might be nice to have a whole painting with as much detail as you possibly could fit in, it won't be as interesting to look at as when you have areas that might be missing some details. Remember, you are there to guide your viewer to look at certain aspects of your painting. You're not there to create a full outline of what they should see. Adding these softer layers goes a long way in giving enough detail without outlining every single shape. When we have a look at the one I spent the most time on, you can see that there is a significant amount of detail added to that one image. And when you have a look at the image in its completed form, here you'll notice that it was really important to get that one focal point done. I might add a little bit of detail over there just so that the eye can be guided through the painting. So let's see how that goes. Remember, we're only trying to lead the eye. We're not giving all the information. You'll see I deliberately leave out a lot of information simply because I wanted this painting to be a soft rendition of these beautiful field flowers. They are really pretty, but they don't last long as cut flowers, and that's why this branch of artificial cosmos can keep in my studio for quite some time. I can paint hundreds more of the exact same ones by just repositioning them, seeing them from another angle, or even adding other elements to it. You'll see in many of my paintings I have quite a variety of artificial plants. Some get gifted to me. When I see something that is beautiful, I'll grab it and bring it home with me. I hope you enjoyed this. See you next time.